Rondo Shanda.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I hope everybody they are here. You are hearing me. Makatose ketelia.
Present.
Rabadoko sote. Okay. Manoko sotelia. Ibarakatose ketelia da 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 da. The first prayer that pastor led, pastor said, he said, Hannah came to herself and said, no. I won't be coming to Shiloh every year and remain the same. No, 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 no. Something must happen. The Bible says she make a step, she made a vow, things happen. She did something, she did her part, but what I am bent on, what I am actually talking about, he said something must happen. Did it happen? Yes, it happened. The man said every year, every time. They will come, trouble the water, trouble the water. Angel will trouble the water before I enter, another one has entered. When will this stop? When will this? But on that day, he didn't leave the water. He remained there. Ah, thank you, Pastor. That's another revelation. He didn't leave the water. He remained there until one day, one day, one day, one day like today. His helper located him by the water. He met with many disadvantages, many discouragement. He remained by the water until this day. There were still many of them at the pool, but he was the one that caught the attention of Jesus. He's been there now for 38 years. Oh my God, that's not a 38 years old person, is not a small boy. So his situation alone was 38 years by one spot, by oh my God, oh my God. Before he entered, another one will enter. That situation kept him by that place for 38 years. I pray today in the name of Jesus, something good will happen for you. Something miracle will happen for you. Something testimony will happen in your life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Something must happen. It must happen. 10 more days. 10 more days before the end of this year. After this night, it's no longer 10, it's 9. And 9 is the number of delivery. Hey, God will do it again. He will do it in your life. He will do it. He will do it. He will do it again in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Ah, yekosapala de kesiada bayada. We are going to pray 8 prayers. But I want you, while you are praying this prayer, remember the story and the testimony of Sarah. Sarah was a woman of many sides. She was a woman of many sides. She was beautiful. She was a good woman. She has so many good qualities. She was a humble wife. She was a wonderful person. She was a matriarch of example to so many godly people. But listen to me. The Bible said God's word one day came to her in her situation. Look, being good does not mean that bad will not happen. But in that situation, oh my God, in that very situation, the Bible said one day, one day, one day, one day, the angels of God visited. Sarah laughed and they said, you will surely laugh. And she laughed. I pray for you as you hear the sound of my voice. God visited Abraham and Sarah in the dying minute of their life, in the ending part of their life, at a point where some people say, if it happened like this, it has happened late. At a point where people told Sarah, it is already late. Can you hear me now? In the name that is above every other name, with God, it is never late. He answered them late. Today, he is a father of many nations. Today, he is a mother of many nations. And God, we say God answered them late. No, no, no. God cannot be late. May God give you a latest miracle. the latest one. This year will not just go and go like, no. I know you've had testimonies this year, but may God give you the latest one. There is another miracle that is cooking. It's in the pot. It's cooking for you, for your wife, for your children, in the name of Jesus, for your family. May God give you the latest one in the name of Jesus Christ. And listen to this scripture. I am reading Matthew chapter 2, verse 16 to 18. Then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth, and he sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in all the coast thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise men. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, in Ramah, listen to this, there was a prophecy that children will die. The names of these children were not mentioned. But when the prophecy was to be fulfilled, it was fulfilled in their time. I pray for you as you hear the sound of my voice. Any negative prophecy that has been happening and is operating, working to happen, waiting to happen in your life today, I decree an end to them. I push them back. I push them out of your life. I stop their movement in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's continue. The Bible says, in Ramah, there was a voice heard, lamentation and weeping, and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children and would not be comforted because they are no more. Listen, brothers and sisters, something must happen. That was why Herod said, you must kill all of them. Something must happen. You did not come bring the address. You did not bring the address, the location of that child to me so that I can go and kill him. Okay. All right. You thought you are wise. All right. You are wise, man. You have escaped. I will kill anybody on my way. Something must happen. If I don't kill that boy, I will kill because of one child. Because of one child. He killed countless. He killed so many innocent children. But while he was giving the order, God was giving another order. While Herod was giving an order, go and kill them, God was giving an order, take him to Egypt. Take him to safety. Take him to a place of safety. I pray for you as you hear the sound of my voice. That which the enemy have decreed to happen, God have decreed that they will not happen to you. In the name of Jesus, I repeat it. That which the enemy have decreed and proposed that it will happen, I decree today it will not happen to you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the precious name of Jesus, that evil will not happen to you. That trouble will not happen to you. Yes. It will not happen to your children. It will not happen in your household. Between now and the remaining 10 days, I decree and I declare, evil shall not knock at your door. They will not enter. They will not enter. It will not be you. In the name of Jesus Christ. The second prayer we are going to pray. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Second prayer we are going to pray. Acts of Apostles chapter 27, verse 22. Acts chapter 27, verse 22. And yet now, I exhort you to take heart, for there will be no loss of life from among you. Only the sheep will be gone. This year will go, but you will not lose your life. This year will not go with your life. This year will not go with the life of your children. This year will not go with your business. It will not go. No. This year will not go with your finances. Yes, in the name of Jesus, this year will not go with your with any valuable that belongs to you, any good that belongs to you, this year will not go with it. He said there shall be no loss. I'm praying for you. You are the one I'm praying for. God send me to you. There shall be no loss. You will not lose your life. You will not lose your children. You will not lose your car. You will not lose your business. You will not lose your money. You will not lose your family members. You will not lose your father. You will not lose your mother. You will not lose your brother. You will not lose your sister. Anything that will bring for tears and weeping shall never come near you. In the name of Jesus, there shall be no loss. From now into the new year, there shall be no loss. You are the one I'm sent to. I pray for you today. You are right in this prayer mountain for a reason. In the name of Jesus, it will happen for you. Something great will happen in your life. Something good will happen in your life. That before this, be expectant, be full of expectation, because it will happen to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Ando kosote libayada, rogo sote kete badakata, loze marako teskiba, ye zaso koto limbaradia kata, le kashu marade ketoska, imbla katoske te beliados kaparada, zekuti marekesia. Number three, the third prayer we are going to pray. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The third prayer is in Luke chapter 18. Luke chapter 18, if you read from verse 1 to 8, you get the full story. You get the full account of the prayer. It's an account of the unjust judge. The judge and the woman who will never take no for an answer. Something must happen. This is a woman that said something must happen. It must happen. So she went the first day, not in the morning she was there. In the afternoon she was there. In between afternoon and evening she was there. In the evening she was there. At night she was there. This judge, the Bible said Jesus called this judge the unjust judge. This judge feared no man. He feared no God. That was how Jesus described this judge. He said, but this woman, he said, lest she weary me. This woman will weary me out. This woman will judge, will make me. She became a thorn in the flesh of this judge. The judge said, I have so many other cases here on my table, but let's answer her first. Let us attend to, look, secretary, all of you, attend to this woman first. Let's judge her case. I need peace. Something must happen. Something must happen for things to happen. I decree and I declare today, in the name of Jesus, even at the end, Jesus, they hear what the unjust judge said. How will God not avenge? I like the word. Anytime Jesus used the word avenge, how will God not avenge his own elect, which cry to him day and night, you are myself. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Let God answer you now speedily, because that is what Jesus said. He said, I tell you, he will answer them speedily. I move you to a realm of speed within 10 days. Within 10 days, Amako teke tus kapala di akaseda. Within 10 days, let God give you unusual speed. Let there be happenings in your life. Positive happenings, miraculous happenings, testimony, favorable happenings in your life, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the precious name of Jesus. The woman did not give up until something happened for her. Until something happened for her. It will happen for you. It will happen for your good. In the name of Jesus, there are people that you know everyone expect will give you gifts. This year, you will get it. There are some things you've been waiting on. It will happen. In the name of Jesus, favors will be coming from left, right, and center. I pray for you. In the name of Jesus, you will not only give to others, but you will receive. You will receive. You will receive good. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Makoto Zeketeliada. Number four, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, because of time. Number four, Esther chapter 4, verse 12 to 16. Oh my God. Esther chapter 4, verse 12 to 16. Powerful scripture. When Esther's words were reported to Mordecai, he sent back this answer to Esther. Do not think that because you are in the king's house, you alone of all the Jews will escape. Don't think so. For if you remain silent at this time, something will happen for us. If Esther, if you choose not to do anything, he says something will happen. He says relief and deliverance. I pray, I command deliverance upon your life right now. I command deliverance upon your life, upon your children, upon your business, upon everything that concerns you. I command deliverance now to happen in the name of Jesus. He said, for if you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place. So God has many places. You don't understand that? Get the revelation, get the rhema. God has many places he can bring the thing from. It doesn't have to be from one place. Akatabayada. He is a God of many places. That was why when he said, if they come in one way, he will scatter them in seven ways. Because he is a God of many places, many sides, many. That was why he said, your ways are not my way. God have ways. No way. He has ways. He is the way, but he has ways. Makato zegeli adabayada. Let's continue. Thank you, Holy. Relief and deliverance for the Jews will arrive from another place. But you and your father's family will perish. He said, and who knows? I like this statement. Who knows? But that you have come to your royal position for such a time as this. Then Esther came to him, to herself. Esther, you see, the no-nonsense statement, the something must happen statement of Mordecai triggered a something must happen effect in her. She said, now, go and tell my uncle. Hey, all of them to fast and pray for me. It is not time for the thing to happen, but it will happen. It is not time for me to go in and see the king. I will enter. It is not time. It is not my turn, but I will enter. If you hear the sound of my voice, I command deliverance that is not time yet to happen to you. I fast forward it to your direction, to your home, to your address, to your life, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You know the story. At the end of the day, Esther got what she wanted. The Jews were free, and the enemies of the Jews were hanged in the very gallows that he prepared for the people of God. I pray for you as you hear the sound of my voice, in the name that is above every other name. What they gang up to do against you will backfire on them. In the name of Jesus, I blew them on their faces. In the name of Jesus, whoever carries sacrifice, to any junction, to any forest, to anywhere, to walk against you, I command the sacrifice to backfire on them. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank somebody shout it three times. Something must happen in the name of Jesus. Mando kosho dekelia. Number five. Mako sotekelia da. Rogo sotekelia. Exodus chapter 14, verse 15. Very powerful scripture. Exodus chapter 14, verse 15. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Tell my children to go forward. Akelia, bakoso, keteli, mana, kataya, degedia. Hey, brother, wish forward. I am super sure that the children of Israel will be asking Moses, Moses, come, which forward? Where is the forward here? Where is for where? Forward where? This is resting in our front. You are telling us forward. In the name that is above every other name, something will happen for you. Where there is no way, he will make a way. Adokosiada bakata. Where there appears to be no way, he will make a way. It only appears that there is no way, but God saw the way. He saw the way in the Red Sea. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. He saw the way because he is the one. He can make way where there appears to be no way. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, who is this person? Whatever they did against you in your dream, I undo them now. In the name of Jesus, there is a way for you. I decree and I declare whatever seed was planted in your life that my heavenly Father never planted, that your maker never planted, I command that thing to get out of your body. Between now and the remaining 10 days of this year, I decree and I declare you are free. Adekebo, somama nakatiade, ededebo kosubalama nakata, izezo kuku marabadi edekata. I decree you are free now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Number six. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Genesis chapter 22, verse 7. Genesis chapter 22, verse 7. Listen to this. Maybe it's familiar to you. Listen to this one. And Isaac spake unto Abraham, his father, and said, my father. And he said, here am I, my son. And he said, behold the fire, and behold the wood. This is it. But where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Where is the lamb for the sacrifice? Where is it? Where is the lamb? Father, where is the lamb? Father, apostle, you all this one, you are saying, where is the lamb? He makes a way. And if this is one of the most difficult questions in the whole Bible, where is the lamb for the sacrifice? At this point in time, even Abraham was confused. At this question, Abraham didn't know what to do at this point in time, but he summoned up courage and said, the Lord will provide. But as far as he was concerned, the Lord has already provided, and the provision was you, Isaac. Hey, but deep down inside, he said, the Lord will provide. He provided. Can I pray for you? In the name that is above every name. What Abraham was trying to say to Isaac, something must happen. Something must happen. Did it happen? It happened. The Bible said there was a ram. The Lord said to Abraham, don't lay hands on that boy. Don't kill him. Today I know. I know you love me. I know you fear me. Today in blessing, I will bless you. And in multiplying, I shall greatly multiply your seed greatly. He said, now look back. There is a ram caught in a thicket. Go get that and sacrifice to me. I pray for someone hearing me now. You are hearing me now. In the name of Jesus. In the name that is above every other name. Whatever appeared to be the most difficult situation in your life, I dissolve them. Yes, I dissolve the riddle. I dissolve the strength of that situation. I decree and I declare you are free indeed in the name of Jesus. Something must happen. Abraham said, Isaac, my son, I don't know what will happen, but I know something will happen. I don't know how it will happen, but I know something will happen. I don't know what is going to come out, but I know something will happen on this mountain here now. Something will happen, and it happened. Today, I pray for divine provision for you. You. I pray for divine provision for you. Liako sapa e kasku teliana. I feel led to pray financial liberty. I pray for you right now for financial liberty, financial liberation. I pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are struggling financially today, I release you from that struggle. I release you from that struggle now. In the name of Jesus, I release your mind. In the name of Jesus, I release you. I release you. I release you spiritually, physically, financially. I release you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Mandokosa. Number seven. Mandokoso keteliada bakayada. Luke chapter 5, verse 18 to 26. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Luke chapter 5. Verse 18 to 26. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And okay, I'm going to read it to you. You'll be amazed. Beautiful story. And behold, men brought in a bed a man which was taken of the palsy, and they sought means to bring him in. Take note, they tried, like Father said, they sought means to bring him in, but they could not because of the multitude. There were so many people there. They went up, they said among themselves, something must happen. We must get our friend to Jesus. We don't care how it happened. We must get our friend to Jesus. We must get to Jesus today. Today, they said, sir, the door is blocked. The windows blocked. There is no way anywhere. They said there's a way. We will make the way. And they climbed the roof. John, climb, remove it. And I imagine what the owner of the building will be thinking at this time. Disruption to the service. Disruption to the revival service. The crusade was temporarily put on hold. Why? Because some people said, today, something must happen. And they removed the roof and they brought down their friend before Jesus. When Jesus, the Bible didn't say when Jesus saw the man, when Jesus saw their faith, when he saw their doggedness and their ruggedness, he said, these guys, something must happen. If something doesn't happen here, they will scatter this crusade ground. So let something must happen now. Something must happen. And Jesus looked at him and said, thy sins be forgiven you. People that were complaining, oh, why will they do this? Why will they do that? They began to question, why will he say, thy sin be forgiven you? What concerns you with the sin issue? Jesus said to them, to the man, rise up, take your bed and go home. And the Bible said the man rose up. The man rose up. I pray for someone under the sound of my voice. I release on you the faith for things to begin to happen for your good. I release on you now the faith, the fire, the passion, the power, the baptism, the grace. The unction for things to begin to happen for your good. I release it on you now. From between now and the remaining part, between now and 10 days, something will happen to you. It will happen for your good. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Mandoko shatalia dada gayada. Leke soto. Something must happen. It must happen today. It must happen. Number 8, the last. Makoshe kabayada, rogoso keteliada bayada. Genesis chapter 32, verse 26. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Makote ziya. Hey, jada da 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 da. Leko soketia. And he said, listen to this. And he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. Please, let me go. And he said, I will not let you go, except you bless me. This is bless me by force. Something must happen. This is not just prayers. Something must happen in your life. Come to that point. Get it down in your spirit. Something must happen. Lord, I come to you. You spoke to me. You spoke to me, and I join my faith with your people now. That something good, something miraculous, something great and wonderful, oh my God, begin to happen to them. Begin to happen in their life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Look at it. He said, let me go. This was the story of Jacob and the angel. Oh, he said, and a man wrestled with him to the break of the day. And when it was getting bright in the day, the angel said, I need to go. I need to go now. I need to leave. I must report back to heaven. Jacob said, you are joking. You don't know what we are saying here. You don't know. You don't know Mission House people. You are joking. I will not let you go. Me, see you, and then you go free. No. You must bless me. The angel said, let me just go. He touched the hollow of his thigh. Jacob was disjointed, but he still held on to the angel. Something must happen. Something must happen. I pray for you in the name that is above every name, that it will happen for your good, and it will become a reference point that you will never forget in your life in a hurry. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible said that at this point in time, the angel began to converse and relate. He was begging him. He was begging. Jacob said, forget it. Don't bless me. Then you go. Bless me first, then you go. It must happen. Blessing must happen to me. I have been hearing testimony of people. My own turn has come. I have been listening. My own turn has come. I have been speaking it. My own turn has come. I have been hearing it. My own turn has come. I have even witnessed people doing their own. My own turn has come. Your own turn has come. It must happen for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Tabo shataliada dagabayada. Legedege sotokoliada bakashata. The angel Jacob grabbed the angel. We will die here today. Angel said, please let me go. Jacob said, you don't know me. You know, if you know my name, and he said, okay, what is your name? He said, my name is Jacob. I can't even bless you with that name. I don't care. Change my name then. If you can't bless me with the name, then change my name. Just bless me. Something must happen for me. I pray for someone hearing me in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let the testimony you long waited for, let it happen. Let it happen. Anokesi kekemarakutataida. Let it happen for your good in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will no longer walk in darkness. Before these 10 days are over, God will surprise you in the name of Jesus. Before these 10 days over, God will surprise you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name forever. Hallelujah. Kobo shate kesiada bada. Rogo do godo zekete limanakaya. Ye gado sekete liada gayado sekete mayada. You are going to shout the name of Jesus 9 times. That's how I'm led. You will shout the name of Jesus 9 times, and you will begin to decree upon your life all that you want to happen. You will start saying it now. All that you want, you desire to happen. You between now and the end of this year until the new year, what you desire to happen, you start saying it. You start saying it. You start saying it. They are spiritual declarations. They are spiritual incantations. As you begin to declare them, it will happen. It will happen. Whatever I hear you say in my ears, I will do it. I will do it. Thank you, Holy Ghost. 9 times. 1, 2, 3, go. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to decree, begin to declare it. Start declaring, start declaring, start declaring, start declaring it. Speak it, speak it, speak it upon your life. What do you want to have? Hey, speak it in the name of Jesus. I command deliverance upon your life. As you are speaking, I command deliverance upon your family. I command deliverance upon your children. I command deliverance upon your wife, upon your husband. I command deliverance upon your ministry. I command deliverance upon your job. I command deliverance upon your certificate. I command deliverance upon your finances. I command deliverance upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Mando kosoketeli adabayada. Imbrogodoko seketele bragadoska.